Hello everyone, now our next experiment is based on the concept of the static binding and dynamic binding. Now what is meant by the binding? The binding is connecting a method call to the method body is known as the binding. So in Java there are the two types of the binding. First is the static binding, it is also known as the early binding. The second binding is dynamic binding and it is also known as late binding. Now let's see what is the static binding. The static binding, when a type of the object is determined at compile time, then it is known as the static binding. The overloaded member functions are selected for invoking by matching the arguments, both type and the number. This information is known to the compiler at the compile time itself. So, and this is called early binding or static linking. And one important thing is that binding of private, final and static methods is done during the compile time. The compiler is aware that these methods cannot be overridden and are always accessed by the object of the local class. Okay, this is all about the static binding. So see here the example of the static binding here. So there is a class, superclass is created here. And in that class, the print method is defined here, whose access modifier is the static. And there is a simple message is displayed by using the println statement. Then there is a subclass is created or subclass is extended by the superclass. So subclass is inherited by the superclass. In that also, the method is defined print method here, static method. Then there is a simple message displayed by using the println statement. So here in the method print, why we are using the static? The static is using because when we use the keyword as a static, the compiler is aware that these methods cannot be overridden. Okay. Next, there is a class static binding here, and in that main method is defined here, and in that main method, the object of the superclass SUP sup is created, and there is another object is created SUB of the superclass. But see here in this statement, the object of the superclass is created SUB, but there is a reference is created of the subclass. So by using this objects of the superclass, the print method is called here. sup.print and sup.print. Then after running the file, you can see the output. Then you can clear the point. See here in the output window, there are the two statements. This is the superclass is displayed here. So why this is the superclass statement is executed two times? Because one, first it is print at this statement sub.print. At that time the print method is called here, which is defined in the superclass. Okay, at that time this method is displayed here. When you call or when sub.print is method, this statement is executed, at that time the print also again the print method which is defined in the superclass is invoked, and the message displayed is this is the superclass. So the message in the subclass or a message which is defined or which is displayed in the method print method in the subclass is not executed because we have declared the method as the static. So at that time compiler is known that when you declare the static keyword, then this method cannot be overridden. So the message this is the superclass is displayed two times. Next, the concept is dynamic binding. Now see here first what is meant by the dynamic binding. Okay, when type of the object is determined at the runtime, then it is known as a dynamic binding. The function is linked with a particular class much later after the compilation. And this process is known as a late binding because it is invoked late after the compilation. Next, it is also known as the dynamic binding because the selection of the appropriate function is done dynamically at runtime. So in this type of the dynamic binding, the method to be called is not decided by the compiler. Understood? So it is not decided by the compiler. An appropriate example for the dynamic binding is overriding. And the parent class and the child class have the same method name. That is the concept of the overriding. Now see here the example or the program of the dynamic binding. Same here the class is created, superclass 1. In that the method is print is defined. The message is displayed. Next, the class subclass 1 is extended or inherited by the superclass 1. And here the print again print method is defined. So here I add the override annotation here because the print method is override here. Then the message is displayed by using the println statement. Then there is a class dynamic binding, and in that main method, the object of the superclass 1 is created. And then again the object of the superclass 1 is created, but references of the subclass. So by using these objects, I have called the print method here. So sub.print and sub.print. Now see here, the concept will clear when you see the output. Now see here the output. This is the superclass and this is the subclass. Now at this time, the message in the subclass is printed here. Why this has happened? Because now we are not using the static keyword here, and the method is overridden here in the superclass and override in the print method in the subclass. Okay, thank you.